Get today popular digital trend article in your inbox. This year Detroit Auto Show started top on a prime note for Moisler Car and Movie Enthusiast for introduce the long awaited 2018 Mustang Bullitt. It's a modern interpretation of the car Steve McQueen famously hung on the street of San Francisco to chase down him 50 years ago. When making a Bullitt, there are certain things it absolutely must have. It has to have the right attitude. It has to be unique in some way from a Mustang GT, and more than anything, it has to be badass. It's land for Mustang chief engineer Kirk Whitman. The blue oval hit the nail on the head when it comes to styling. The Bullitt comes standard in dark highland green, attribute to the original. The buyer can order shadow black. It also receives subtle chrome action around the grill and the window, and it drives on 19-inch spoke wheel. Notice it doesn't come with chai, deco, or even emblem. Sato T characterizes the Bullitt 10 and now offer only as a coupe. The Bullitt is based on the latest Mustang GT, but for unreleased technical specifications. Yet, the only morsel of information published tells us power comes from an upgraded version of the GTS 5.0 gạch nối LITERV 8 Turbo Makeover 475 horsepower and 420 pound-feet of torque. We're expecting the final output will lie in the vicinity of 500 mã lực bolted to a 6-speed manual transmission. The 8-cylinder sender Bullitt to a top speed of 163 dặm/giờ, is 8 dặm/giờ faster than the normal GT. If you're a keeping check, the 2019 Ford Mustang Bullitt will reach showroom over the summer. The list of options include Recaro bucket seat, a semi-active suspension, and the Bullitt electronic package with bundle feature like navigation useful for finding shortcut, SUJ bad guy, and an upgraded system. Pricing information and technical specification will be released in the coming month. Reunited in Detroit for display the modern day Bullitt with its predecessor from 1968. It's one of the two car that star in the movie, and even the subject shorter motif historian believe the car was lost until very recently. Warner Bros. Sold it to a private buyer after it finished filming Bullitt, and it ended up in the hand of enthusiast Robert Kiernan. His son inherited it in 2014 and agreed to show it in public at the Detroit Show. You know, it was never our intention to keep this car a secret from everybody. It just kind of happened with life. I'm just completely buzzing to join it for and the new Bullitt and show this car to the world on one of the biggest stages. There is, Kiernan said, editor recommendation.